Hi, good morning everyone. Welcome to chapter 5, rational numbers. Under this, we already done what are the positive rational numbers and what are negative rational numbers, in which numerator denominator has same sign, we call it a positive rational number, and when numerator denominator has opposite sign, we call it negative denominator. We already done how to represent rational numbers on a number line. Further, we will do rational numbers in standard form. How you will write rational numbers in standard form? First of all, I want to repeat that thing. What is rational numbers? Actually, in this natural numbers, you consider all like starting from 1, 2, 3 up to infinity numbers. If you add 0, 0 means whole number starting from 0. And if you all negative natural numbers like that, that becomes integer. Integer means all natural numbers, whole numbers, and all negative numbers are included. And if you add fraction in these numbers, so that is the combination. Fraction means terminating numbers when remainder is zero. When you divide numerator by denominator, you get the remainder zero. Though after decimal also, if remainder is zero after division, at particular point we call it terminating numbers. So that numbers we call it considered as a category of rational numbers. Here under this rational numbers in standard form, so question is how you reduce. If you have any fraction is given, doesn't matter it is negative rational numbers or positive rational numbers, so how you reduce in the lowest form. First of all, main thing is if any rational number denominator is negative, make it positive. Okay, so we divide numerator denominator by HCF. Then after that we find the HCF. Whatever HCF we found, we divide numerator denominator by both to convert into the lowest form of the fraction. Like here, if I have some question like 14 by 56, first what I will do, I find the HCF. I have two methods of find the HCF. One is division method, like this 14 fours are 56, then 14 is also 56 is also divisible by 14, so that means 14 is the HCF of 14 and 56. But if I go with another method like 14 and 56, so we take only common number, not like LCM, because what in LCM what you do, if any number is divisible by any number, you divide by that number. But here when you are going to find the HCF, you only have to divide the number when all the numbers will be divisible. Like here, 2 7s are 14, 2 28s are 56. Now 7 1s are 7, 7 4s are 28. It means you have to consider only right number here. You have to write only number here which is divisible by all the number present in this common number. It is doesn't mean like that LCM. Okay, because I know that 3, 2, 7s are 14, 2, 28s are 56. Both are divisible by 2. Then I think about the next number. Both number are divisible by which number? Here if I look at 28, 28 is also divisible by 2. If it is the condition of LCM, then I can take 2. But it is the condition of HCF. Then I have to think about both the numbers. Both number has common multiple will be there. Then you have to do like 7 1s are 7, 7 4s are 28. Then you have to ignore this number. Whatever common number you have to write here, 2 into 7, that is 14. Either you have to done this way or this way. Both which is comfortable you can done with that way. Now after finding the HCF, you divide numerator denominator by that HCF, you get the lowest form of the fraction. Similarly, if I have a negative numerator and positive denominator, condition is same, you have to still find the HCF. Now if I go with division method, 45 divided by 10 gives me 445 left as remainder. Next, before previous divisor become the dividend for the next, and 5 become the divisor. 5 2s are 10. That means 5 is the highest common factor of 10 and 45. But if I go with this matter like 10, 45, I think about the common number divisible by both the numbers like 5. Both come in 5 table. 5 2s are 10, 5 9s are 45. And 2 and 9 both come in not in, both are not coming in any common table. So we leave as it is. Only what is written here common number, that is considered as HCF. When you divide numerator denominator by HCF, that means minus 2 by 9, but numerator is negative sign, that will also accompany in your answer. But what happen when your denominator is negative? So what you will do, first you try to make the denominator positive by multiplying negative sign, numerator, denominator both, or simply you can if your common denominator is a negative sign is there, you can write in the numerator, or you can 32 by minus 60 into minus 1 by minus 1 also gives you minus 32, and negative negative becomes positive, so that means that gives you 60. Now HCF of 32 and 60 is 4. When I find the HCF by long division method, 60 divided by 32, 32 ones are 32, remainder is 28, 21s are 28 and remainder is 4, 4 7s are 28, and 4 is the common factor between 32 and 60. If I go with this method, 32 and 60, I think about the common number. Both is the multiple of, come in a 2 table or multiple of 2. 2 16s are 32, 2 30s are 60. Again both come in 2 table, then 2 8s are 16, 2 15s are 30. Now 8 and 15, there is no common table between that, then we left as it is, and whatever common number we find, we multiply 2 into 2, 4, 4 is the HCF. Now you divide numerator denominator by HCF, you get the answer 4 8s are 32, 4 15s are 60. And negative sign, whatever in numerator, that is also accompanied with the numerator. Next is equivalent rational number. So what are equivalent rational numbers? Two rational number can be reduced to the same standard form, then they are equivalent rational number. If you have any one rational number is there, and you have to arrange that fraction in a like equivalent fraction, you already done that in equivalent fraction, like if you multiply any term with the denominator, same term should be multiply or divide with the numerator, denominator both. If you are multiply, then both numerator denominator multiply with the same number. If you divide, then both the numerator denominator will be divided by the same term. After multiplication, either division or multiplication, what fraction you get, that is considered as equivalent fraction. Suppose I have a question, find two equivalent rational numbers of minus 30 and 33. So what I think, first I will do, I think about the two numbers. So I multiply with numerator, denominator both. Numerator first multiply by 2, then denominator also multiply by 2. That gives me minus 60 by 66. So similarly, if I divide by 3, because I think that 30 and 33 both comes in 3 table, then you divide by 3, that gives you minus 10 by 11. Either you divide, either you multiply, your whatever your fraction you get after is called the equivalent fraction. Now if you want to check if two fraction you have given, whether they are equivalent or not, I check, like I pick this one, minus 30, 33 and minus 10 upon 11, I want to check whether they are equivalent or not. So what I do, I just multiply, cross multiply with each other, minus 10 multiply by 33 and 11 multiply minus 30. Then I check what is term after calculation, what terms come in left hand side and what terms come in right hand side. When I multiply minus 10 into 33, that gives me minus 330. But right side, when I multiply minus 30 into 11, that gives me minus 330, that is the same term. This way you can check whether your fractions are equivalent or not. If you have two fractions are given, equivalent or not. And another thing is that when you are going to convert any fraction into equivalent fraction, remember one thing, either you multiply or either you divide, any either numerator either denominator, don't forget to multiply or divide the other number also. Means, simple words, if you multiply a denominator with any number, same number should also be multiplied with the numerator to make it a balance of the fraction. Similarly, if you divide numerator with any number, the same number should be divided by the denominator also. So that is compulsory to make a equivalent fraction or balance the fraction. Sometimes what happens, student forget if in denominator they multiply anything, but they forgot to multiply with the numerator. In that case, your fraction will be wrong. It will not be balanced and it will not be equivalent fraction. In that case, your fraction is totally changed. So to balance the fraction, to make it equivalent fraction, because when you reduce in the again smallest form, you get the same fraction again. So for that, remember, anything when you any number multiply with either numerator or denominator, same number should be multiplied with the other number also, and if same with the division also, if you divide by the denominator, same number should be divided by the numerator. Next is rational number between two rational numbers. If I have a question, I have to find what is the rational number between two rational numbers. So I have the simple method to make it a equivalent fraction instead of finding the average. Average becomes the bigger one. So if I have a question, find the three rational numbers between 1 by 25 and 1 by 5. First, you have to convert this into equivalent fractions or equivalent rational numbers. For that, if it is 25 and it is 5, okay, then 25 is a multiple of 5, so directly convert this into 25. So here is 1 by 25, so make it equivalent fraction. LCM of 25 and 5 is 25. So if you multiply the term denominator with 5 to make it the LCM 25, numerator also should be multiplied with the 5. Here, when you go with the LCM, 25 and 5, LCM of 25 and 5 is 25, because when you find like 25 and 5, like here, 5 5s are 25, 5 1s are 5, 5 1s are 5, and here is a 5 into 5, that gives you 25. So this is 1 by 25 and 5 by 25. Okay, remember one thing, there are infinite rational numbers between any two unlike rational numbers. These are unlike rational numbers. Okay, so first you convert into equivalent fraction, then you can write number of whatever numbers come between that, you can write. Okay, now here if you think, now denominator is same and my numerator numbers are 1 to 5. Now you have to concentrate only on the numerator. So it means when you check the number between 1 and 5, like here, numbers are 2, 3, 4. It means 1 is less than 2, 2 is less than 3, 3 is less than 4, 4 is less than 5. So it means doesn't matter if denominator is common, but you have to think about the numerator. If your denominator is same, you arrange the directly numerator into ascending order, like here. 1 by 25 less than 2 by 25 less than 3 by 25 less than 4 by 25 less than 5 by 25. So if they ask for the rational number between 1 by 25 and 1 by 5, so these are the 2 by 25, 3 by 25 and 4 by 25. These three are considered as the rational numbers between 1 by 25, and this 5 by 25, when you convert into lowest form, that becomes again 1 by 5. That was your previous rational number. Next is, what is the absolute value of rational numbers? Absolute value means what is the distance of particular number from the zero, like in integers. If it is a zero, okay. So here is a, you very well know that here is a positive side, here is a negative side. Okay, so if there is a 1, there is minus 1. So 0 up to 1. So how much if person moves starting from 0 and reach at 1, so it will cover 1 unit distance, then 2, it will cover also 1 and 2, 2 unit distance. Similarly, when person moves on this side or this side, so here though number is negative, but it covers a distance 1 unit, 2 unit, because distance never calculate in the negative form. Distance always calculate in the positive form. Suppose person is standing at 2 and he reach at minus 2. When you count the distance, how many units he covered the distance? Like 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 unit. We doesn't consider that it is a negative number on that place is there. But if person moves starting from particular point, how many unit he is covers? Doesn't matter it is negative sign or positive sign. So that is considered as your distance. In simple words, we call it a absolute value. Absolute value means if any rational number, there is a negative sign is there, you can ignore the negative sign. If I have a absolute value of 2 by 5, so this modulus sign is considered as you are going to find the absolute value of 2 by 5. So that is 2 by 5. But if I have a negative rational number absolute value of minus 7 by 13, so I write in a modulus minus 7 by 13, and after when this two parallel lines remove, your answer will be 7 by 13. Similarly, if there is a negative term in the denominator, also same thing, if you have to going to find the absolute value, you write under two parallel lines, and this negative sign will be merged under this, and your answer will be 9, positive. Ultimately, question is that if you have to find the absolute value of rational number, if it is positive rational number, then your answer will be as it is. But if it is negative rational number, then negative sign will be ignored, and your answer will be as a positive rational number, because positive number and absolute value shows that is the positive distance from the zero. Because absolute value of rational number is the distance of the number from zero on the number line. Regardless of direction, it is always positive. Direction always measure in the positive form, and in absolute value, we always count the distance. We doesn't count the direction where it goes positive or negative. We always count the distance, which is always positive. It will be never negative, and doesn't matter wherever you go. An absolute value is considered as distance from the ground position. Ground position means zero position, how much distance you cover, either upward or either downward. Next is comparing and ordering rational numbers. So I have two methods for comparing and ordering rational numbers. First method is how you compare if you have given two rational numbers on a number line. So if I have a line like that, so already you know that how to represent rational number in a number line. First, when you are going to represent a rational number on a number line, check the denominator. If denominator is 4, denominator is 3, you divide 0 to 1 number into 3 equal parts. You can measure the scale according to that. It will be considered as 3 equal parts, and you have to mark 1 after that. So if I have a 2 rational numbers 1 by 2 or 1 by 4, so 1 by 2. First convert into equivalent fraction, it will be easier for me. So here 2 by 4 and 1 by 4, because LCM of 2 and 4 is 4. So to make it a denominator 4, I multiply numerator and denominator both by 2. Here 0 and 1. Now I mark the position. Here it is 1, 2, 3 and 4. But if it is 1 is there, that means that position is first point among the 4 points. We write 1 upon 4. That means same as in fraction, like out of 4 there is considered as 1 part. Out of 4 there is considered as 2 part. Out of 4 there is considered as 4 part. And that means out of 4 that is considered as 4 parts. After cancellation it becomes again 1. So when I check, mark 2 by 4 is here and 1 by 4 is here. So that means 1 by 4 is less than 2 by 4. Next, Comparison of rational numbers of equivalent fraction. How you compare the fraction by making it equivalent fraction? Rule is that first thing, whenever you have fraction is given, you make the positive denominator. Okay. After making the positive denominator, find the LCM of all the denominators. After finding the LCM, arrange all the rational numbers into that particular fraction as the same as LCM, as equivalent fraction. After that, if any number numerator is greater, then arrange in that order, either ascending or descending order. Okay. If I have a number, like find the greater rational numbers of 5 by minus 7 and 7 by minus 5. If I have two numbers like that, first thing I have to make this as a denominator positive by multiplying both numerator and denominator by minus 1. That is minus 5 by plus 7. Similarly, another number 7 by minus 1 also multiply by minus 1 to make it a positive denominator. That is the most important thing. First you have to make the positive denominator. Now you have to check both denominator. Now you have the number minus 5 by 7 and minus 7 by 5. When you check the LCM, LCM of 7 and 5 is equal to 35. Okay, now you convert each fraction as a denominator as same as LCM, that is 35. So which number I have to multiply by 7, that gives me 35, 5. So same number numerator also should be multiplied with the same number, that gives me minus 25 by 35. Similarly, another number minus 7 by 5. Now 5 should be multiplied by 7 to give me as a denominator 35. Same number should also be multiplied with the numerator to balance the equation, minus 49 by 35. Now I have two number, denominator is same, so I check among minus 25 and minus 49 which number is greater. Minus 49, if you see on the number line, like here, when you check the, this is negative terms, this is positive term, this is positive side, this is negative side. So here minus 49 comes here and here minus 25. That means when you are going to move to increasing order, like lower to higher order, so you have to move this way. When you move up to this way, so that means minus 25 is greater number and minus 49 is lesser number. See, doesn't matter whatever denominator is there, but denominator should be same. Then you check about the numerator. So that will be your required answer, and you convert it back into your original fraction. Minus 5 by 7 is greater than minus 7 by 5. Next is, arrange the following rational numbers in descending order. Similarly, if the previous question was what happened, there is only two fractions, but here if condition is that if you have more fraction, how you arrange into this into the descending order? Descending order means decreasing order. Higher number should be first position and lowest number afterward. If you want to arrange into ascending order, lowest number should be in first position and you have to move to the higher order. Now condition is same. First, if any number is denominator is negative, make it a positive. Like here, 7 minus 6 is my negative rational number where denominator is negative. Other term, denominator is positive, we write as it is, but whatever negative denominator is there, by multiplying both numerator and denominator by minus 1, you make it a positive denominator. Minus 5 by 6, 9 by 12. So that gives you 1 by 3, minus 7 by 6, 5 by 6 and 9 by 12. Now you have to find the LCM. LCM of 3, 6 and 12. 3, 6 and 12. When you go with the LCM, it goes on first 2 table. 2, 3 are 6, 2, 6 are 12. Again 2 table. 2, 3 are 6. Now 3 table. So ultimately my LCM is 2 into 2 into 4. When you multiply 4 into 3 gives me 12. Then LCM of 3, 6 and 12 is equal to 12. Now what you have done now, you arrange all the fraction as a denominator same as LCM. Now you convert all the denominator in the form of 12. Like here, 1 by 3 when you multiply by 4, numerator also should be multiplied. 4 by 12 minus 7 by 6 into 2 gives 6 into 2 gives you 12, and numerator also should be multiplied by 2. 7 into 2 minus 14 minus 7 into 2 gives you minus 14 by 12, that is 5 by 6 into 2, so that gives you 10 by 12. Now 9 by 12, so that is already 12 as denominator, no need to change. Now your terms are 4 by 12 minus 14 by 12, 10 by 12 and 9 by 12. Okay, if it's a condition of arrange and descending order, first you have to think whose number has numerator is higher. This is higher, so that should be written in the first position. Lowest is 9 by 12, 4 by 12, then last is negative minus 4 by 12. Then arrange back into original fraction, like 5 by 6, that is 5 by 6, bigger one is 5 by 6, then 10 by 12 is greater than the 9 by 12. Here is also minus 5 by 6, sorry. So this is minus 5 by 6 and that gives you minus 10. Now that is a lower one. So this will be here. So 9 by 12 is the bigger one. Lowest one is 4 by 12. And here minus 10 by 12 will become. Minus 10 by 12. Then smallest one is minus 14. Because when you go in the decreasing order in your number line, here is your number line, this is positive sign, this is negative sign, when you move left to right, so that is your increasing order, and when you move right to left, so this is decreasing order. So in decreasing order, here minus 10 come first and minus 14 comes later, so you have to arrange like that. It means now you arrange into fractions. 9 by 12, so that is a bigger one. 4 by 12, that is the lowest one. Then 9 by 13, then you write 9 by 12 is greater than 1 by 3. Then 1 by 3 is greater than minus 10 by 12. Minus 10 by 12 fraction is minus 5 by 6. And last is minus 14, that is minus 7 by 6. This you have to arrange in your descending order. Greater than, lowest one, then at last smallest one. Similarly, next is properties of rational numbers. So there are three conditions of properties of rational numbers. First condition is that if I have only one rational number, so there will be a condition. Either that rational number will be greater than 0, either equal to 0, or less than 0. So that is if I have a one rational numbers, so there is a possibility of three conditions. Either it will be greater than 0, equal to 0, or less than 0. Suppose I have a number like 7 by 9. Okay, so I know that if 7 by 9 will be positive, that will be greater than 0. If it will be equal to 0, then it should be numerator should be 0. It will be like that. But if it is less than 0, so what are the condition where rational number is 0? If it is negative, minus 7 by 9, so that is considered as less than 0. But what happens if you have given two rational numbers like A and B? If you have two rational numbers, so there also three conditions arises. Either A is greater than B, either A is equal to B, and either A is less than B. So there is a possible three conditions of two rational numbers. Suppose I have a number 5 and minus 2. So example, 5 is greater than minus 2, okay, or you can write 5 is equal to 25 by 5, two different numbers. When you divide this 1 by 5 also give you 5, or you can write 5 is less than 25. So there is a possibility of two condition. But what happen if there is a three rational number like A, B and C? Also there is a condition, either A is greater than both the numbers, okay. If A is greater than B, B is greater than C, so that means A is greater than all the numbers. This condition is that if A is greater than B and B is also greater than C, so you can directly write A is greater than C, same from the other numbers also. Like for example, if 2 is greater than 1 and 1 is greater than 1 by 2, so you can directly write 2 is greater than 1 is greater than minus 1 by 2, sorry. If 2 is greater than 1, 1 is greater than minus 1 by 2, I can directly write here 2 is greater than minus 1 by 2. Similarly, if A is greater than B and B is greater than C, that means we can also write directly A is greater than C also. If A is greater than B, B number is greater than C, B number is bigger one than C, then you can also write this A is greater than C. Thank you. Have a nice day.